that old rascal Mr. Fox has attacked the poultry that live in this enclosure, and you can see where he did the deed. There's still a few hens here. He hasn't taken them all. He took a duck, and a couple of hens have gone, and I've gone around the perimeter and helped the owner repair the fence. I'm just checking around here. I'll show you one of the repairs. The problem is that the posts in places are becoming rotten now, and the fence is becoming old. It's been here for 7 years and there's been no issue with the fox getting in, but I had to patch up some of the areas. We think the fox is getting in around the back here. This is one of the areas he's getting in. But we kind of done a running repair. And there's more repair going on down here. So what I plan on doing, setting up a trail camera with the timestamp on it, and we can actually time when this fox comes to this premises, and then we can make a decision on whatever action to take. But the fox isn't necessarily the rascal that he's made out to be, although he's devastated many small holdings and their hens in the past. He's only, of course, doing what he's programmed to do by his nature. He can't help it. Anyway, I'm just thinking where I'm going to put my trail cam. I want it to look along this fence here. So I'll bring you back when I have the trail cam up. That's the SD card formatting. Now, I believe the fox has a place. And it's very upsetting when things are killed like that by the fox, and obviously he can't help himself. And the best way to deal with it is to, well, that's it, we're counting down now, is to make your poultry pen as fox-proof as possible. In the past, I have had to use the harshest measures to deal with an errant fox, but it's not something that I undertake to do lightly. I'd rather live with the fox and allow him to have his life, because he's entitled as much to his life as I'm entitled to mine. That's the way I think about it. So hopefully we'll catch Mr. Fox on the camera. I'm just walking around with the owner at the moment, just checking the poultry to make sure. You caught one then?
Well, I got one chicken.
Yeah.
And you put them into roost.
But the duck won't go in.
Well, they like roosting. Outside.
Yeah, yeah.
But
safe for them, is it though?
Not safe.
No.
Going in.
Yeah, put them away. If you want to make your poultry fox proof, this is the way to do it.
Thank you.
Well, our fox didn't show again, so I removed the camera from that location. But I recorded these images of the fox or foxes in my own garden, and they come into our garden every night, and we have at least three or four foxes. And my view of the fox is that it is all part of the balance of nature. The fox, he goes around and he cleans up dead, decaying matter, thus stopping the spread of bacteria. Any weak animals he takes out, which then stops the weak animals from breeding and perhaps weakening that species. If he gets into your chicken coop, he'll kill every chicken if he gets a chance, and then run off with one. But then what people don't realise is that over the course of the next few days, he will come back, he'll take every carcass, and nothing will be wasted. So Mr. Fox isn't all bad, but there are instances where alternative action needs to be taken, and perhaps these are where game birds are reared, or where there are lambs. But really the onus is on us, the owners of the poultry, to make sure that our pens are as fox-proof as possible. Mr. Fox is an ally. Mr. Fox is a hero. He does good work, and he's all part of the balance of nature. Did I call Mr. Fox a hero? Oh, some of the time. Most of the time I think he actually is. But of course sometimes he isn't. And it's that balance, isn't it? He's got to eat. We've got to eat. Anyway, I'm walking down to the end of my road where there are some allotments, and I'm pretty sure I'll be able to see a fox. There are lots of them around here. I'll spin you round. I'll turn the light on. We have a fox. There, can you see? Middle of the screen. Two little shiny eyes. That's Mr. Fox. He's blinking at us. I'll see if I can get closer. There he is. Mr. Fox. Down the allotments. You can get to within about 30 or 40 yards of them, and then that seems to be their sort of circle of what they'll tolerate, and then they go. Anyway, time to head back in.